Today, I'm going to be telling you all about Roundups, a lifetime deal over on AppSumo that utilizes AI technology to generate affiliate articles. So the way this works is you'll connect up your Amazon Associates account or your AppSumo affiliate account, pick out some products, and then Roundups is going to create an article comparing those products for you using your own affiliate links. So you don't even need to search through the article and update it with your links. It's very frictionless, but how well does it work? Well, I've been trying it out and I've got some thoughts. My name is Dave, by the way. I review lifetime deals every single day of the week. I'm an affiliate marketer myself. This video is not sponsored, so if you want to support this content, I've got an AppSumo affiliate link down below. If you want to pick up Roundups or anything else at AppSumo, I greatly appreciate it if you click my link before doing so. Now, onwards to the AppSumo deal page for Roundups. It starts off at just $59, and that is in fact the plan that I'm using to make this video. But if you really like the platform and you want more, of course, AppSumo has options for that. You can spend up to $500 on this tool. Essentially, what we're looking at is how many articles we can write per month. So they call those roundups. So that's an article, although you can have a roundup with just one product, just so you know. So we can do 10 for tier one, 50 articles per month on tier two, and unlimited on tier three. Now, the only other thing to take into consideration when picking out your plan is how many products you want in your roundup. For me, 10 is plenty. I can't imagine doing a roundup with more than 10 products. I actually think you'll probably get better success as an affiliate marketer by limiting the number of products because otherwise people get analysis paralysis. But if you want more, you can get 25 on tier two or 50 on tier three. All right, let's just cut right to the chase. I've been using this tool. I've got thoughts. I want to show you what one of the outputs looks like here. Now, I do want to add in that I'm currently just hosting this right on Roundups, but they do have integrations with both Ghost, which is my preferred blogging platform, as well as WordPress. So you can connect up your accounts and then just export these posts directly to your website. Oh, and I should add, if you're not using either of those platforms, you can download the HTML and just put it wherever you'd like. So here's what a blog post looks like. It looks pretty good, honestly. Like, we get a headline at the top. The AI did everything. We'll go through the process so you can see what it looks like to create one. But we've got a little intro section here, top picks, and then it just goes through and it basically reviews all of the microphones. Now, this was one where I basically chose 10 different microphones and had it compare the different microphones. And down at the very bottom, we're gonna see, if I scroll way, way down, we're gonna see a comparison chart, which I find to be very, very useful. Here is another roundup that I did. Now, I'm in the admin area here, so you can see all of my options for sharing and publishing it to my website and things like that. But this one is for AppSumo products. So here I compared three CRMs. I chose Clippy, Swipe One, and Blue, and you can see it grabbed the images from AppSumo, and it included my affiliate link after I connected up my affiliate account. I'll show you how to do that momentarily as well. And then as we go through, at the very bottom, there is an FAQ section here and another comparison table. Now, because this one only had three products, it's got a different format for the table. I really like how this looks. Nice and clean and simple. It's not quite up to, let's say, like wire cutter design standards, but it's not half bad either. Looks kind of techy and like you'd see on a lot of those tech review websites. So yeah, I mean, I'm okay with the design. I really just have two main gripes, and we'll go over that as we go through this process here. But essentially, to create a new roundup, you just go right up here and click this button. Now, I highly recommend before doing that, you go over to My Integrations and you set up either your Amazon or AppSumo account prior to creating content. Now, it does try to update articles if you change the affiliate account you want to link it to, but it's not perfect, and that's one of my two gripes. In fact, we can just get into this right now. So for example, these links here at the top for, say, the Rode PodMic, if I hover over it in the lower left-hand corner, you can see my Amazon affiliate link. It ends with profitable 2-20. If it ends with that, it's my Amazon affiliate link. Well, when you actually create the article, if you don't have that set up ahead of time, the little chart down here at the bottom never gets updated and it uses their affiliate link. So that can be a big bummer because I can imagine a lot of people would utilize this chart. And even though there's an editor for these blog posts, there's currently no way to edit the chart itself. So I guess that's my real major problem with the platform right now is there's a bug where the product comparison tables are not updated if you add in your own affiliate links. So the solution to that is simple. Just before you create new content, get connected up with Amazon or AppSumo. The process for doing so, by the way, is extremely easy for Amazon. You just simply paste in your affiliate ID, which you'll see at the top of your screen when you're logged in as an Amazon affiliate. The process to connect up your AppSumo account is quite easy as well. Assuming you're already an AppSumo affiliate, you'll be used to the platform called Impact. That's what AppSumo uses for their affiliate tracking. And here you'll just need to go in and grant them access via the API. So you'll get your account SID and your auth token. There's directions here in this little guide exactly on how to find it. Basically, you go to the triple dots here, click on API access, get the codes, and then just paste them into Roundups. Once you do that, any content you've already generated will be automatically updated with your affiliate links, with the exception of the comparison table, which is currently got that little bug. All right, I'm just gonna go over my other gripe right now, and then I'll actually show you how easy it is to generate the content, because overall, I think this is a pretty usable platform, but my other gripe is the size of the images. They're just huge. There's no way to resize them at all either. There is a nice editor, but it doesn't have the ability to resize images. So I think a way to fix this would be to set like a maximum size, let's say 600 pixels. So nothing wider, nothing taller than 600 pixels, automatically resizing it. That would go a long way. Otherwise, you know, this is basically filling up the entire field of view on my monitor to see this one microphone. Okay, so let's go ahead and we'll make an article here. I'll show you the editor, and this will be a very simple in and out video. So let's create a new Roundup right here. We've got a five-step process. We choose our source, so that's going to be Amazon or AppSumo. Then you also need to mention who you're creating your content about. That's in the source section. Then we'll go through focus, style, headlines, and then finally pick our product. So let's do that right now. I'll make another AppSumo review right here. So this is my audience avatar that I use with Claude all the time. And if you want to know more about how I'm utilizing Claude or any other like AI tools that are not LTD related, let me know down below. I could consider making more regular content about that. So now we're going to proceed to the next step, which is focus. This is where we're going to choose essentially the topic of our video. They're going to suggest some categories here. If I was doing this for Amazon, they'd suggest like Amazon categories, but you can type in your own category on Amazon, whereas with AppSumo, you can't. You have to choose one of the categories that already exists on AppSumo. I think that just makes sense. So let's say I wanted to make a video comparing calendar and scheduling tools that are on AppSumo. I know there's some good ones there. I will choose this. Now, very nicely, they do supply some SEO data here so I can see how likely I am to rank for this particular category. In fact, I can even choose particular keywords that I want to work into my content. So let's say this one right here, appointment scheduling software, Google Calendar, has low competition level, but 1,900 searches per month. That's not nothing. So maybe I would add that in. I just check this box and then it'll be added to my article. Truth be told, I'm gonna leave that out for now, but I think that's a really nice part of the tool itself is it does a little bit of the SEO research for you. Okay, so I wanna focus just on calendar apps here. If you wanted to add in other things, let's say like SEO, you could definitely do that, but I don't wanna blur the lines. So I'm gonna make this article laser targeted on scheduling tools. So we'll go to the next screen where we're gonna choose our style. So we've got a lot of different tones for our article here, from conversational to persuasive or humorous. You can choose whatever you like. I'm gonna choose one maybe a little off the path here. Let's choose like sarcastic and just see how good a job it does at being sarcastic. Next up, we can choose our language. It supports a lot of languages here. If I had to eyeball it, I'd say, you know, it's roughly like 50 or so different languages. It's definitely not everything in the world, but yeah, you got a lot to choose from. Then we choose the point of view for the written content in the article. So is it going to be saying, I experienced this, or is it going to be more guiding you, like you should choose this if that sort of thing. So we've got first person, second person, or third person. I'm gonna go with first person for my article. And then I can choose a format here, a single product. So basically a review of a single product, head-to-head comparison, three column layout, or a ranker. This is going to be where you choose multiple products and it's going to rank them from say 1 to 10 or something like that. Now, I've already shown you a ranker. That was my microphone article. Here it is, looks pretty good. This is what their comparison table looks like. And I also showed you the three column layout. That was the first AppSumo article I showed you. So for this, I'm gonna go with head to head. And I do have the option to turn off the comparison table if I don't want that. I don't see a way to do this later on. So make sure you decide as you're creating the content, whether or not you want the comparison tables. So I'm gonna go with the head to head article and we'll proceed to the next screen. All right, now it's taken what I've given it about my audience. Remember, I gave it a pretty good user avatar. And then I also chose a focus that I wanted to focus on scheduling tools. And it's taken those two things, combined them, and given me some headlines to choose from here. So they're all pretty decent looking. Two scheduling apps that will totally change your life. How to pretend you're organized with these two scheduling solutions, the ultimate guide to calendar tools. Now, I think, in my opinion, it might be better if they gave you the headline option after you choose the products, because that way you could include the product name inside the actual headline. Now, I can write my own headline down here. If I knew what I was gonna make the video about, I could just type it in. Or I could have it generate more ideas if I didn't like any of the options that it gave me. But I think my point about including a product name in the actual headline is pretty strong, especially for single product reviews or head-to-head comparisons like this, where you definitely want to call out the products because usually people are trying to decide between two more popular tools. Now, I do notice that all of the headlines that were generated are very sarcastic and not necessarily in a good way, like why you need yet another calendar app in 2025. Spoiler, you don't. So that's probably just because I chose kind of maybe not the best tone for this type of article. I could always go back and change it, right? So we'll go to style here and let's do, how about, I don't know, conversational sounds good. So now that I've changed the tone, it's regenerating the headlines and they're a lot less snarky and kind of less stupid in my opinion. So the future of scheduling, top tools for 2025, streamline your business with two essential scheduling solutions. You get the point. All right, I'm gonna choose this one right here, master your calendar with these game-changing apps, and we'll proceed to the next step. Now here is where I can actually choose my products. With the Amazon selector, you can actually paste in Amazon links of specific products, which is pretty nice. Unfortunately, you can't do that for AppSumo, which makes it a little bit tedious, especially if you already know what products you want to review. You kind of got to take with what they give you. Now, it does say you can change or add product categories, but I need a button here in order to add in a particular tool. For now, I'm going to go with TidyCal and ZCal, which is currently sold out, but we'll still review those two tools and find out which one the AI says is best. Oh, by the way, that's another thing I would like a filter for, is to be able to hide products that are currently sold out when I'm generating new content. I think that would be really helpful. Now, before I go ahead and create the roundup, I do want to point out that you can sort the results here. So I can choose by price, by rating, by the number of reviews. It's going to default to most popular. But yeah, I really would love to have a little search box for both the Amazon one, honestly, and for AppSumo, if I could just type in a product name. The most tedious part about this is picking the apps, and it shouldn't be that way. Okay, so we're good to go here. I'm going to create the roundup. I've got the two tools that I want, and it is generating my article. In my experience, it takes anywhere from 60 seconds to 3 minutes to actually have the article up and ready to go. So really no time at all. So right now it's generating the article. And as you might've noticed up here, it says they're gonna email me when the draft is ready. And that's true, they do email you. So you don't have to sit here on the screen. You can just come back when it's ready to go, review it. We're gonna look at the editor in a moment, show you how that works. And if you like it, you can publish it over to your blog or just use their service to host it and you can share it right on social media. Oh, there we go, it is ready. So let's go ahead and click on the view action here. And here is what our review looks like, or our roundup looks like. We've got an intro section up here. We've got the best overall as TidyCal and the best value as ZCal, which is interesting as ZCal is more expensive than TidyCal. Now, I might want to change that because it doesn't make sense. So what I can do is click right here and edit the post. And maybe I'll just say best power user. I don't know if that's the best thing to say, but you get the idea here that you're not stuck with the AI generated content. You can add your own personality into it. In fact, I'd love if there was another step in the creation process that had actually asked your opinion on the products. For example, I make these individual reviews. It'd be very easy for me to just copy and paste the transcript of the reviews into this tool, and it could utilize that to help craft a more thorough roundup. So here's the editor. It's nothing special. It's just kind of a standard WYSIWYG editor. We've got different levels of headlines here. You can add in code or quotes, and you can attach images if you want to add them to your article. But yeah, otherwise very, very plain and simple. Like I mentioned before, there is no way to resize these images. So if you find them to be a little too large, you're kind of stuck. We can reorganize the items. So even if I had 50 items over here, I can easily drag and drop them to put them into a different order. Let's say I wanted to make Zcal number one, Tidy Cal number two. I can rearrange them and then regenerate the content. So it's going through the generation process again here, but very, very flexible in terms of just getting everything to lay out in the way that you want. All right, so it's been regenerated. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. So now Zcal is on the top. And it says best overall is Zcal and best value is Tidycal, which honestly makes a lot more sense. Over here, I could copy the formatted text or copy the HTML, and I could also publish to WordPress or Ghost, which I'm not gonna cover in this video, but it's pretty simple to do so. Now, Roundups is also gonna give you an open graph image, which you can see over here. I can edit this image and choose the product that I'd like featured. You can see it's kind of over here in the corner. Let's say I wanted Zcal to be featured. I'll choose that and it redoes the image. Now, keep in mind that once you publish this over to WordPress or Ghost, you can replace it with whatever you like. I'm not a huge fan of what this looks like, especially considering that it has the Roundups logo. I think it could be a really great service if they just let you replace the Roundups logo with your own logo, because then at least you have something that's on brand. But as it is, you know, it's better than leaving it blank. All right, so we're just about done here. A few more things to cover. The article does end with an FAQ, and then there is the comparison table. The head-to-head comparison table looks very much like the three-column comparison table, just, you know, with the product listed, their pros and cons, and price. Okay, so there is Roundups. Overall, it does a pretty good job of doing what it says it's going to do. I just wish it were a little bit more customizable. The editor is pretty good, but not great. The blog posts look okay, but not amazing. So overall, I think it deserves about a 6.7 out of 10. All right, we're gonna wrap this video up, but I do wanna point out that AppSumo is currently running a Valentine's Day sale. So if you spend more than $100 before noon on Valentine's Day, they'll give you $10 off. You can find out more about that with my link in the description to pick up Roundups or anything else over at AppSumo. My name is Dave. Thank you for watching. Hit me up with any questions in the comments. Like the video if you like the video, and I'll see you in the next review.